Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sneha and welcome back to PerioHub. Hope you all are doing great. So today let's understand the topic of gingivitis. Now we've spoken about inflammation and what exactly does the term itis mean. So itis always denotes inflammation. So what is gingivitis? It is nothing but the inflammation of the gums. So the plaque, the calculus, the debris, the microorganisms associated with the plaque. So they eventually cause inflammation of the gums, which is termed as gingivitis. Now we've spoken in detail about inflammation and the other clinical signs and symptoms associated with gingivitis, and I'll be linking those videos somewhere on the screen so that you can check it out. But today specifically we will be talking about how exactly does this inflammation of the gums occur. So what are the stages of gingival inflammation? So the stages of gingivitis are broadly divided into four categories, and this was given by Page and Schroeder somewhere between 1972 to 1976, and they basically divided this disease entity into four major events. So firstly, here we have the initial lesion, which then progresses into the early lesion, and if it is not arrested at this stage, then it will then advance into the established lesion, and ultimately it will go into the advanced lesion. So this is the way in which the disease progression would occur. Now, one more important aspect to understand over here is that the first three stages are reversible stages. That means that if the patient maintains the oral hygiene and the plaque and the calculus is removed, then the disease progression is arrested and the gingiva comes back to health. But in case of the advanced lesion, this is an irreversible condition. It cannot be reverted back. That means the state of health cannot be brought back to absolutely normal conditions. Now, one more thing that we need to understand is that when we talk about these lesions, we will be talking in respect to two aspects. So we will be discussing about the clinical aspects that can be clinically observed and visualized, and we will be talking about the histopath aspects in which we need to take a small cross section of the gingiva and observe it under the microscope. So first let's talk about the initial lesion, which is also the stage one. And this occurs between 2 to 4 days of plaque accumulation, and this is also called as the subclinical gingivitis state. Now, why is it called as subclinical gingivitis? Because the signs and symptoms which are associated with inflammation, which means the cardinal signs, are not really apparent in the gingiva. So what are the cardinal signs? So a quick revision. So cardinal signs involves heat, redness, swelling, pain, and loss of function. So if you can see this particular clinical picture, you can see that the gingiva really looks normal, but still we can observe some specks of plaque and calculus in certain areas. Now let's move on to the histopath aspect of it. So firstly, let's talk about the epithelium. So here we have a plaque which is there for about 2 to 4 days, and because of the microorganisms in the plaque which will release certain byproducts, the epithelium in defense will start releasing certain pro-inflammatory cytokines. So cytokines such as interleukin 1, beta, interleukin 8, prostaglandins, tumor necrotic factors. So all these cytokines are released by the epithelium, and along with that there are certain defensins and antimicrobial peptides which are also released by the epithelium. Again, we've spoken in detail about the antimicrobial peptides, and I'll be linking the video somewhere on the screen. Now, in case of the connective tissue, there is vasodilatation which is occurring. Now, vasodilatation again is a step of inflammation. So, if we have a blood vessel here, it would dilate, and there is increase in the blood flow that occurs. So, because of the increased blood flow, there is increase in the GCF production that also occurs. And the connective tissue which is present around the blood vessel, which is also called as the perivascular space, shows certain destruction. The third important aspect that occurs in the connective tissue is the cells. So you can appreciate certain PMNs which will migrate into the gingival sulcus. So along with the PMNs, you can also see certain lymphocytes which get accumulated. Now let's move on to the second stage, which is the stage of early lesion. Now early lesion occurs between 4 to 7 days, and as you can see here, we can see all the clinical signs and symptoms which are associated with inflammation. So we can see the gingiva, which is slightly erythematous in nature, and also there is bleeding on probing. So remember, when there is bleeding on probing, we can say that the lesion has progressed into the early lesion stage. So talking about the histopathological changes, first let's talk about the epithelium. So between the connective tissue and the epithelium, reti ridges are formed. This basically helps to increase the surface area, and this is important for the migration of the neutrophils. So here the neutrophils from the blood vessels will move through the chemotactic gradient, and because of the increased surface area, it will move into the epithelium, and the whole process of phagocytosis of the microorganisms will begin in this particular stage. Now talking about the blood vessels per se, there is increased proliferation of blood vessels. So they increase in number, and this is the major cause which leads to the erythematous change. So this is what gives it the reddish hue. And the perivascular area, that is the area which is present around the blood vessel, the destruction will keep increasing, and almost 70% of the collagen which is present in the perivascular area are destroyed. Now along with that, there are gingival fibers which are present. So we have the dentogingival group, we have the sulcular group. So the destruction of these fibers also occurs. So we can see a lot of release of MMPs. So MMP 2, MMP 9. So these are the major MMPs which are associated with the collagen destruction that is occurring. So established lesion is also called as the stage 3, and it occurs between 14 to 21 days of plaque accumulation. Now clinically, if we observe this lesion in the oral cavity, we can see a lot of erythema which is associated with a bluish hue. Now why a bluish hue? We will be talking about this aspect a little later. And the gingiva can profusely bleed even with slight provocation. Now moving on to the histopathological aspects. So here if we talk about the epithelium, both the junctional epithelium and sulcular epithelium will show ulceration. So there is a break in the continuity which is seen in the epithelium, and there is ulcer formation leading to even the exposure of the connective tissue. So the connective tissue opens up into the oral cavity. Now within the connective tissue itself, again the blood vessels, there is a proliferation of the blood vessels which is occurring. Now along with that, because of vasodilatation and increased vascular permeability, the blood becomes a little sluggish in flow. So the blood will become thick and it will not flow in a correct manner. So this particular aspect is termed as blood stasis. So there is increased blood stasis that is happening, and this results in a localized area of anexemia. That means there is deficiency in the concentration of oxygen. Now this whole process of blood stasis and decreased venous return, and along with decreased concentration of oxygen, leads to the bluish hue of the gingiva. Now let's talk about the cells which are mainly seen during this stage. Now the amount of neutrophils which are seen in the initial and the early stage are now slowly replaced by the plasma cells. So plasma cells are the cells which produce antibodies. So we can observe a lot of quantity of IgG1 and IgG3 type of antibodies within the connective tissue. Now remember, till this particular stage, that is from stage 1 to stage 3, the condition is reversible. That means if we administer good oral hygiene techniques and the patient is able to maintain a good oral hygiene status, then we can go back to the state of health. But once we move on to the fourth stage, which is the final stage, that is the advanced lesion, the condition becomes irreversible. So this is basically a stage of periodontitis where we can see a lot of inflammation of the gingiva along with periodontal destruction. So as you can see, there is recession in this area, and in the canine area there is loss of teeth. So this is a phase of periodontal breakdown. Now let's talk about the histopath aspect. First let's talk about the epithelium per se. Again, the epithelium will show ulcerations which can expose the connective tissues in certain areas, and along with that the junctional epithelium shows apical migration. So the cells which are present in the coronal aspect between the tooth and the epithelium, that is the DAT cells, the hemidesmosomal attachment is broken down, and slowly the junctional epithelium will apically migrate. Now, talking about the connective tissue, again, there is a lot of vascular proliferation which is seen. There is vasodilatation, increased vascular permeability. Along with that, there is blood stasis which is occurring and impaired venous return. Now, along with that, inside the connective tissue, we can see a lot of bacteria that gets access. So we've spoken about the ulceration that has occurred in the epithelium, and through this ulceration the bacteria and its byproducts get access into the connective tissue, and these byproducts can start attacking the alveolar bone also and cause the destruction of the alveolar bone. So essentially there is destruction of the periodontal apparatus. Now, the cells which are again associated with it are mostly the plasma cells, and they keep producing the antibodies to combat the microorganisms which have now got access into the connective tissue. So with this, we finish our topic on the stages of gingivitis. We essentially spoke about the four stages involving the initial, the early, the established, and the advanced lesion. So remember the IEEA stages of gingivitis. So with this, we come to an end of this particular topic, and I hope you liked and found this video helpful. And if you did, then you know the drill. Please like, share, comment, and tap the notification button to get notified every time we upload a video. I'll be meeting you guys very soon, and until we meet next, take care of yourself. This is PerioHub signing off.